now. She won't trust you.
My friends, we're wasting time, which should be spent in facing up to our predicament. I fear that Salmo's threats weren't made in sport.
Do you think he'd have the nerve to go to court?
I'm sure he won't. They find it all too true.
A case of swindling and ingratitude.
Don't be too sure. He won't be at a loss to give his claims a high and righteous gloss. And clever rogues with far less valid cause have trapped their victims in a web of lies. I say again that to antagonize a man so strongly armed is most unwise. I wish to heaven that we could devise some sort of truce between you, or a compromise.
If I had known what cards he'd held, I'd not have roused his anger by my little plot.
Who is that fellow? What is he looking for? Go talk to him. Tell him I'm busy.
Good day, dear sister. Kindly let me see your master.
Involved with company and cannot be disturbed just now, I fear.
I hate to intrude, but what has brought me here will not disturb your master. In any event, my news will make him most content.
Your name?
Just say the angering greetings from Monsieur Tartuffe, on whose behalf I come.
Sir, he's a very gracious man and bears a message from Tartuffe, which he declares will make you most content.
Upon my word, I think this man had best be seen and heard.
Perhaps he has some sentiment to suggest. How shall I treat him? What matter will be best?
Control your anger. And if he should mention the fair adjustment, give him your full attention.
Good health to you, good sir. May heaven confound your enemies, and may your joys abound.
A gentle salutation. It confirms my guess that he's here to offer terms.
I've always held your family most dear. I've served your father, sir, for many a year.
Sir, I must ask your pardon. To my shame, I cannot recall your face or name.
Loyal's my name. I come from Normandy, and I'm a bailiff, in all modesty. For 40 years, praise God, it's been my boast to serve with honor in that vital post. And I am here, sir, if you'll permit, liberty to serve you with this writ.
To what?
What?
What? What? Now, please, sir, let us have no friction. It's nothing but an order of eviction. You are to move your goods and family out, and make way for new occupants without deferment or delay. And give the keys to...
I'll leave this house?
Why, yes, sir, if you please. This house, sir, from the cellar to the roof, belongs now to the good Monsieur Tartuffe, and he's lord and master of your estate by virtue of a deed of present date, drawn in due form with flurious legal phrasing.
Your insolence is utterly amazing!
Young man, my business here is not with you, but with your wise and temperate father who, like every worthy citizen, stands in awe of justice, and would never obstruct the law.
But
not for a million, sir, would you rebel against authority. I know that well. You'll not make trouble or interfere with the execution of my duties here.
Someone may execute a smart tattoo on that black jacket of yours before you're through.
Sir, bid your son be silent. I much regret having to mention such a nasty threat of violence in writing my report.
This man Loyal's a most disloyal sort.
I love all men of upright character. And when I agreed to serve these papers, sir, it was with your feeling that I had in mind. I couldn't bear to see this case assigned to someone else who might esteem you less and so subject you to unpleasantness.
What is more unpleasant than asking a man to leave his house and home?
You get a short reprieve. If you desire, sir, I shall not press you, but wait until tomorrow to dispossess you. Splendid! I'll come back and spend the night here then, most quietly with half a score of men. For form's sake, you might bring me, just before you go to bed, the keys to your front door. But bright and early, sir, you must be quick and move out all your furniture, every stick. The men I'll bring are both young and strong, and with their help, it shouldn't take you long.
I may be all but bankrupt, but I vow I give 100 louis here and now, just for the pleasure of landing one good clout right on the end of that complacent snout.
Careful, don't make things worse.
Well, my boots all itch just to give that beggar a good kick in the britches.
Muster Loyal. I'd love to hear the whack of a stout stick across your fine, broad back.
Take care. A woman, too, may go to jail if she uses threatening language to a bailiff.
Enough, enough, sir. This must not go on. Give me that paper, please, and then be gone.
Well, au revoir. God give you all good cheer.
May God confound you and him who sent you here. Now, mother, was I right or not? This writ should change your notion of Tartuffe a bit. Do you perceive this villainy at last?
I'm thunderstruck. I'm utterly aghast.
Oh, Tom, be fair. Well, you mustn't take offense at this new proof of his benevolence. He's acting out of selfless love, I know. Material things enslave the soul, and so he's kindly arranged for liberation from all that might endanger your salvation. salvation.
Will you not ever hold your tongue, you dunce?
Come, you must take some action, and at once.
Go tell the world of the low trick you strive. The deed of gift is surely nullified by such behavior, and public rage will not permit the wretch to carry out his plot.
Sir! Though I hate to bring you more bad news, such is the danger that I cannot choose. The scoundrel who imposed upon you so denounced you to the king an hour ago, and, as supporting evidence, displayed the strong box of a certain renegade, whose secret papers, so he testified, you had disloyally agreed to hide. I don't know what charges may be pressed, but there's a warrant for your arrest. Tartuffe has been instructed, furthermore, to guide you as an officer to your door.
He's clearly done this to facilitate a seizure of your house and your estate.
That man, I must say, is a vicious beast. Quick,
sir, you mustn't tarry in the least. Let loose no time, or you shall be undone. The sole defense in this case is to run. I shall go with you all the way and place you in a safe refuge to which they'll never trace you.
Alas, dear boy, I wish that I could show you all my gratitude for everything I owe you. But now is not the time, I pray the Lord, that I may live to give you your reward. Farewell, my dears. Be careful.
Brother, hurry. We shall take care of this. You need to hurry.
Gently, sir. Gently. Stay right where you are. There's no need for haste. Your lodging isn't far. You're off to prison by order of the prince.
This is the crowning blow, you wretch. And since it means my total ruin and defeat, your villainy is at last complete.
Oh, there's no reason to provoke me. It's no use.
Those who serve heaven must expect of you.
Your lot of duty is most notorious, and what you've done is little short of glorious.
All deeds are glorious, madam, which obey the sovereign prince who sent me here today.
I rescued you when you were destitute. Have you forgotten that? You think it was brute?
Oh, no. No, I well remember everything. But my first duty is to serve my king. And that obligation is so paramount. Then other things beside it do not count. And for it, I would sacrifice my wife, my family, my friend, or my own life.
Hypocrite!
If it's true that you're animated by pure and loyal zeal, as you have stated, why weren't you moved to give your evidence until your outraged host had driven you hence? And if he is a traitor, as you declare, how could you condescend to be his heir?
Do spare me all this clamor. It's growing shrill. Please, carry out your orders, if you will.
Yes, I've delayed too long, sir. Thank you kindly. You are just the proper person to remind me. Come, you are off to run the other borders. In the king's prison, according to his orders.
To who I? This can't be true.
Yes, I owe an explanation, but not to you. Sir, all is well. Rest easy and be grateful. We serve a prince to whom all sham is hateful. A prince who sees into our inmost hearts and can't be fooled by any trickster's arts. He honors righteous men of every kind, yet his zeal for virtue is not blind. With one keen glance, the king perceived the whole perverseness and corruption of his soul. And thus high heaven's justice was displayed, betraying you. The rogue stood self-betrayed. The king soon recognized Tartuffe as one notorious by another name who'd done so many vicious crimes that one could fill 10 volumes with them and be writing still. Your private papers, by the king's command, I hereby seize and give into your hand. The king, by royal order, invalidates the deed which gave this rascal your estates and pardons furthermore your grave offense of harboring an exile's documents. By these deeds, our prince rewards you for your loyal deeds in the late civil war, and shows how heartfelt is his satisfaction in recompensing any worthy action, how he prizes merit, and how he makes more of men's virtues than of their mistakes.
Heaven be praised.
I breathe again, at last.
We're safe. I can't believe the danger's past.
Well, traitor, now you see.
Aha, brother, please. Let's not descend to such indignity. Leave the poor wretch to his unhappy fate and don't say anything to aggravate his present woes, but rather hope that he will soon embrace an honest piety. Meanwhile, go kneel before your sovereign's throne and thank him for the mercies he he has shown.
That's well said. Let's all go, gladly kneeling, and express the gratitude which we all are feeling. Then, once the first great duty has been done, we'll turn with pleasure to a second one. And give Valet, whose love has proven so true, the wedding happiness which is his due.
Guys.